Welcome to Battle for Beyond. Here at the edge of time, where the hands of fate linger just out of sight, beckoning with but a single threatening finger. But it is in hands of a different nature our challengers find themselves today. In the throes of combat with a being whose ferocity is only matched by their unbridled passion for the art of war. And I mean other things too. If we're being honest, there's other passions that are simmering just underneath the surface, looking at you, Brennan. But it is not our tiefling Nikhil who is being pummeled at this time. It is not our paladin warlock who is being folded like a lawn chair, but rather two of our other heroes who find themselves in a very strange predicament today. So, Econ, Lenore, you realize with a sinking feeling, because your feet are actually sinking, that the sand you're standing on is taking the shape of a palm, and you see fingers start to rise behind you. We're already in initiative, so this is just gonna happen, and it is his turn. So this is, I just would like to say as your DM, I'm not sorry. I'm not. Econ, Lenore, give me a strength or dexterity check.
Okay.
Acrobatics or athletics?
21.
Yes. Also 21.
Yes!
And it's a nat 20 for me.
Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Sorry.
No, it's not.
No, it rolled again. Sorry. Okay, if you look at the last one,
okay,
Erica can.
I thought it.
It's in the log. It's in the log.
Why are you fucking lying? We can see your rolls here.
No, it's in the log.
Thank you for that.
All right. So, with a 20 and a 21, a nat 20, bringing it to a 21. You are able to avoid being grappled by this giant hand. Because you've succeeded, it pushes you 5 feet, or no, 15 feet out. So, yeah, as the fingers come up with your successful checks, you're able to dodge out of the way.
Okay.
And so are you. You're able to push your way past the fingers just as they're closing on you. In doing so, this pushes you back 15 feet. You've successfully evaded this creature that is trying to quite literally crush you within the palm of its small hand. Merdina, what do you do?
We've got Nikhil, you're above, right?
10 feet over, yeah.
You're above, and Cestia, you're just...
I am off the map.
Right.
Do not look for me.
I don't know, yeah.
Wow, she's really off the
Stop
map.
Stop pulling she's me far off the map. I went where I went.
All right, Merdina is going to wind up with her claymore swinging all around her to try and create a gust of wind straight towards Nikhil, because I heard he likes it. And ideally, if he consents, allows me to move him further away from this sandy sandstorm creature.
Yeah,
Whee!
Nikhil is so self-absorbed, I don't think he would be aware of it, but... yeah, go ahead and give me a, how do we want to do this?
I elect to fail. Mm-hmm.
That works.
Mm-hmm. I elect to
fail. I'll look up, coming right for ya.
I'm doing this!
Merdina, you just hear a really gentle, like, thanks for getting him out of the way. From the fog of war, you cannot see me.
Right.
Yes, a 10 feet wide cone of air pushes you, you said directly up?
Yeah, I think it's 15 feet up. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Never mind.
Yeah, so you move 15 feet directly up. Is that your turn?
Yes, I will then just stand, you know, and make faces at the sand.
Mug the desert.
Yeah. My poor Cestia.
So he's just...
Unfortunately, we must drag you, kicking and screaming, back
me onto
into
the
throes of battle. I know.
Why am I here?
No.
You ain't getting away from me. I like you too much. What do you do?
I get dragged into the ability to be perceived. You're just 15 feet higher up, but still directly overhead, mm-hmm. My bad boy, right?
Yeah.
I'm now 25 let me drag feet his, above.
Cool. Yeah. Let me drag his token over.
Cool. Maybe you could get out of the way of the thing I was... Fine. Gagging bolt. So instead of using call lightning again, I'll just generate the bolt myself.
Mm-hmm. How big is call lightning? 5 foot radius?
5 foot radius, that's 10 foot.
I mean, no, truly no offense to Abaddon the Architect. He's a big, beefy boy.
He's a thick,
if
he's
you
a
want, thick boy. I'm like, if there's so much aim to hit, I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, thank you. And we do as we have always done. Mm-hmm. Please make a DC 14 dexterity save.
Maybe I'll be dexterous this time.
Please don't.
No, hopefully not, actually.
Please do not. Would be great.
11.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Cool. 14 points of lightning damage.
Perfect.
And then bonus action, archer again.
Perfect. Go ahead and roll
and
the hit.
And then I run back away from this. I leave the map again. Look.
I really dig your whole style.
Look, some of us are for like getting the audience into it. Some of us are not going to be smushed in the hands.
Yeah, go ahead and.
19 hit.
That hits. Perfect.
Sweet. Criminy, and 4 points of radiant damage on top of that.
4 points of radiant damage, yeah.
I'm gonna go, goodbye. Ignore the second one. And run back off the map.
Yeah, the second hit gets mitigated as he, from the ground, conjures yet another sort of like stone piece of like shielding. He pulls it right out of the sands, deflecting half of the damage of your second blow.
Okay.
He's then going to use the rest of his reaction to fling it.
At me? That would be
make
bad.
More sense to go for Layla and Econ because they are together.
Agreed. I leave.
Agreed.
Goodbye.
I love this.
And I
wait,
exit Sestia, the combat.
Where are you going?
Sorry, I got you from back here, y'all.
Layla, Econ, you hear
I'm gonna
this?
Get hit too.
As
nope.
You see it. A giant piece of rock
no.
come flying towards you. Both of you give me dex saving throws.
All right.
Five.
Oh no.
Oh no. Oh no.
14.
The 14 makes it. So you'll only take half damage from this. 15 points of damage, Layla. The rock hits you just about square in the side of your shoulder. You're pushed back by the sheer force of it. And Econ, a piece of it after it hits Layla, kind of with a one last like piece of like sort of trajectory hits you as well.
Okay.
Ah. A beam of light shoots back in reaction. Mm-hmm. Hellish rebuke.
Perfect.
Let's go.
Yes. Nice.
I definitely did make that dex save. He's not a dexterous boy.
Nah.
Noted.
11.
Sick.
Amazing. So as this like collides with you and you go flying, it is your turn, Econ. Lenore, you're on deck.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So Econ runs up to him, casting.
Whoa.
A third level of Adain's feast, Angry Feast. Mm-hmm. And he goes, it's time to show you what my feast can do.
This group is not mature enough for that.
Hey, you know?
It is time.
That's what I'm talking about.
And so I will.
No!
You had advantage from Guiding Bolt.
Oh!
I didn't Guiding Bolt.
Oh,
yeah.
No!
Should've done
that was
I'm
a,
so sorry.
A 9 to hit.
Yeah.
Roller
coaster. You see the sands shift deceptively, and where you initially aimed, where there was a form, kind of sifts out of place as your fist swings wide. Lenore.
Econ, is that what you wanted to do? I'm going to.
Wow.
I'll come help you.
Shame.
I will cast. Word of Radiance. Mm-hmm. So that is a constitution of 14 save.
Okay. Ten.
Okay, so that's gonna fail, so that'll hit. And that's gonna do 6 points of radiant damage. Mm-hmm. And my whole body is now erupting with radiance. And then Ooh. I am going to move, I'm gonna move sort of back along this wall here so that I'm a little closer to Layla and Econ and a little out of the way. And then I will use my bonus action to fling my spiritual weapon one more time. Let's and go. That is gonna be a, that's only a 14 to hit.
That does not hit.
Okay, great. So it's just like the bird sickle spirit weapon is just like floating in the air. It just like, it just swings straight over the top of his head.
He's really tall, yeah. But it's trying. Maybe
yeah,
trying
it's
to
trying.
Give him a haircut.
I really misjudged how tall he was. Like in my brain, he was like another 30 feet
Got
tall.
You.
Yeah.
Your sickle.
It was like just under Nick Hill.
Yeah. Nickel, you dodge this blow as the sickle swings underneath your feet. Layla, Nickel, you're on deck.
Command. Yes. Yield.
Yes.
Whoa.
I told you last time he's like charmed. Immune to charm.
Right. Okay. But it's not that he has to make a wisdom saving throw.
Oh, okay.
It's not the charm condition. Yes.
Yeah. Not charm condition.
Okay. So you say yield.
Shit.
Got 16.
Damn it.
14. Damn.
He says no.
Yeah. All right. You're doing great, Layla.
Shield.
You see an eyebrow form in the sandy clay mass, and so he goes, nice try. Nicole, you hear the rumbling voice underneath you say, no, nice try.
To me?
No, to me.
Oh, sorry, gotcha. Yeah. I got it. I'm like, there's the eyebrow. And I'm and I'm going
His
to-
His only weakness.
His only weakness is the eyebrows. It's like a little 2D scroll, like eyebrow. No, hit the eyebrow, it appeared. Cool, I'm going to swoop down and we're gonna do another two lance attacks.
Perfect.
Yeah. We're not gonna get fancy with it this time. Okay, so we're gonna go first lance attack. 23 to hit.
Hits.
Nice. And I'll do another lance attack as well. 21 to hit.
Oh, whoo, let's go.
Okay, so this is going to be, we're gonna, you know what? I'm gonna throw my last smites on here. I'm all out of spell slots. Mm-hmm. So it's gonna be 4d8 plus 2d12 plus 16.
Let's go.
plus 16 is 56 points of damage.
56 Whoa. Points of damage. Yeah. You think your strategy works. As this creature's eyebrow like kind of shears off, you notice his resolve weaken a little bit, but then you see his face kind of contort into anger, and all the small faces formed of mud and sand on his arms and legs also kind of contort in anger. And he says, playtime is over. And as he says this,
Uh-oh.
He's going to... Are you going to stay there?
So is this happening as a reaction during my turn or at the end of my turn?
At the end of your turn.
In that case, I'm 25 feet up. Rather than allowing him to do his whole whatever turn to me, I'm going to use my remaining 15 feet of movement to get back up to 25 feet overhead. 25 feet above wherever the top of his head is. And I'll take whatever, you know, opportunity attacks.
Yeah. Sweet. 16?
16 does not hit.
Ooh, he swings go. And misses. Oof. So how many feet up are you now?
I don't know how many feet above the ground I am. I'm 25 feet above the top of his head.
25 feet above the top of his head. Okay, so he's gonna make two fist attacks. One down on, because you're within 5 feet of each other, Merdina and Econ, the second on Nico. Mm-hmm. This is the first one.
23.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. 18 bludgeoning damage.
Ooh.
The fist comes down, crunching against Econ and Merdina. Your scale mail deflects some of the blow, but it's still a grievous one. The second fist goes flying in the air, almost from the ground now, because it's not attached to him anymore, towards Nikhil. Wild. That's a 19?
19 misses, Shield of Faith.
Perfect.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So the second one smacks against your, like almost like this, like, these hexes form in the air around you, and it smacks against it, missing. You hear him, like, kind of chuckle and say, I like that you let your friends bleed for you.
Man, I gotta stay focused.
And it's Verdina's turn.
All right, I will just immediately spit out some sand and then go for two claymore strikes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Let's go.
The spit hits my dying body.
Wait, are you down again?
Yep, I'm down.
No, wait, are you?
Yeah.
Are you
no
what?
Again?
Yeah, I was at 15. Again? I was at 15 HP.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, man.
I have to come over here and get you. Okay, well, yeah.
Who knew the
sun? Am I able to?
It was
like,
so painful.
Push Econ's
so soft
body back.
When you walk on it.
You can carry it back. You could use your, like.
And just give it a. You know what?
You'll take an op attack, I think, but. Because his reaction is back up.
Yeah, I'm so worried about Econ. This is the second time. I'm gonna scoop up Econ and run to deposit him next to Lenore, taking whatever, op attack may come.
Okay.
And perfect. Then run back, but yeah.
Yeah, I think you have the requisite strength to be able to carry him. He's not like a...
I think so.
Not to be racist, but can you do anything with water?
You'd think more than I can, but...
Okay. I want to yell during and be like, but, yeah, if y'all back the hell up, but you're all so close.
21.
Yes, that hits.
As you try to flee with Econ's dying body, you take... 15 points of bludgeoning damage.
Okay.
As the fist collides against your back, kind of almost pushing you forward with his like limp form in your hands.
Right. So I'd like
would you like to do anything with your bonus action?
Yes. I'm going to second wind.
Okay,
heal
perfect.
Myself. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so Econ, I'm going to put you like next to Lenore, and then I'm going to run back to where I am though.
Okay. So that's 5, 10, 15. Oh yeah, you have the. Do you have 30 feet of movement? Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Yeah, he's hiding in the rubble.
Yeah, and I will.
We made him a little cradle.
Perfect.
Ooh. I heal. Four plus six, I heal 10.
And Merdina's gone. She's out of the way too. Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no, she came back.
She came back.
Came back over.
You say this as it is now your turn. You're like, you came back
you
over.
You came back up.
And kicking and screaming, we bring Cestia back onto the battle map.
I walk over and I'm like, we gotta coordinate better. Well, you're a Trident tidal wave.
Perfect.
Yeah! And I'm gonna hit him with a woe before, just to make it a little harder to do the DC 14 dex save.
Yeah.
Please
perfect.
Be a bigger number. Take 5 off of whatever you roll.
Heck yeah!
Let's go! Like, she can swim. We're good. This is fine.
Oh, I like how I drop on.
So what? Do I need to do something?
You should roll a dex save.
Yeah, yes. You're going to have to roll a dex save. 16 points of bludgeoning damage.
Perfect.
What could have been a better roll?
Not going to do it.
Not going to do it.
God damn it.
16?
Yeah.
Shit.
Okay.
Oof. And you're knocked prone.
Oh no!
I'm immune to being knocked prone.
That's fair.
Dope.
You heard me, baby. I said go away, and then you came back.
I thought you were talking in the cube.
So you fall.
Me? Get hit by a wave of 50 feet in the air?
Yeah, flying does seem very, very convenient right now.
You're so far away, I couldn't hear you. I couldn't see you.
I feel like you heard me and just not being respected because I'm not visually a part of the fight
wrong?
At all.
Did I not
no,
do
you're
enough?
Fine. It's fine. I'm sorry.
So the water goes rushing forth, tearing through the bottom half of Abaddon, the architect, and also striking Merdina at the same time. Merdina, you fall prone from the sheer rushing of water.
With my bonus action. Though.
Yeah, of course.
Sorry.
And then the water tears through the bottom half of the architect, but he maintains his suspension.
Okay, did it look like water did anything particularly spicy to him?
Looks like it did the opposite.
Oh no!
You see the clay harden and almost become shield-like.
Huh.
Although you see some of it blow off and disperse.
Okay. Huh. Mm-hmm. Water bad, maybe fire good. Wind. We're learning. This is a learning experience.
Yeah.
Starry form, archer. Mm-hmm. I draw the constellation. 20 to hit.
Boom, that hits.
Boom.
For another 9 points of radiant damage.
Yeah. Perfect.
As I go, I'll be back with a new idea. Walk back off the map. Mm-hmm. I look at the crowd and go, I'm sorry, I'm not more engaging.
But you are alive.
Yeah.
You can give me a death save.
All right. Oof. That is going to be 11.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I'm so nervous.
Oh.
You cling to life. Yet. Barely. But it's rough. Ooh. Lenore, you see Econ's not looking too good form next to you.
Econ, you got punched again.
And I'm going to cast Cure Wounds.
Perfect.
All right, this is gonna be a level 3 cure wounds. Oh, 27!
Ooh,
let's go!
Econ, wake up! There's still a fight going on,
okay.
And you're a warrior.
Yes.
So you have to get out there and prove that you're a better warrior than some eyebrow daddy who hangs out in a bathtub all day.
This is true.
Take this, eyebrow daddy, and
my spirit's pulled up again.
Roll the hit.
It's a 9. That's gonna miss. So it's like the spiritual weapon goes up because it was already way up in the air, and now it just like comes down to the side of him where none of my allies are. So it's like on the outside side, like towards where Sestia ran to, and it's like, oops. Still gotta work on my aim with that thing a little bit.
It's okay, you're doing great. Why is this over here? Are you gonna try to hit me?
No. I think he's a lot bigger than he is. I think something about the stature of his character.
There's something about the depth, because I accidentally hit Merdina because I couldn't really judge it.
Yeah.
He tricks the eye.
I understand.
Yeah, thank you. You're doing great.
Thank you, you too.
Thanks.
Layla.
I cast Dissonant Whispers, and he hears a voice, or you all hear a voice that says, though my lips don't move, and it says, you try year after year, cycle after cycle, and you fail, and you become addicted to that. Love the thrill of the chase.
Yeah.
You wouldn't know what to do.
Yeah.
You're empty inside. You're not failing.
I'm not even gonna roll for it. But here is my gambit. As you say this to him, you realize the same applies to you. Roll damage.
Oh, dang.
May you roll well.
15.
You both take 15 points of psychic damage. As you are filled with your own regret. For you hear, you feel it like inside you. You feel like a voice start to emerge of, have we not done the same?
You see a flash of recognition across the face, and I stumble back, and I move. I don't know where or how, just back away from it.
Yeah, you almost move back away from each other, almost like some type of forced energy has like transpired between the both of you. Both of you move back. His movement speed is really slow because he's very big. And you both like stumble back from each other and almost for a moment acknowledge each other's mutual pain.
As he backs away, can I strike him?
You're on the floor.
Just get my
ankle.
Kick.
His ankle.
You can attack with disadvantage.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, let me see.
Yeah, okay.
Prawn makes you bad at fighting, but you can do a nasty, messy swing.
Yeah, the creature has disadvantage on attack rolls. You could try.
You could try to stab
him in the ankle.
You might as well. What's the harm in?
Yeah, that's that dirty fighting we like.
Just bite his ankle.
Bite his ankle.
Yeah.
Fight his nuts and kick him in him.
All right, let's see. So two rolls. What was the lower one? Oh my gosh. Where's this? Oh, it added. So the lower one's 10 plus that, so 17.
That hits.
Yes! Ooh, how do you like trees? Nice.
Yeah. From the ground, yeah. 8 damage.
Amazing.
Hey.
Yeah, you're able to strike out his ankles as he stumbles backwards. Nikhil, it is your turn.
Hell yeah. I'm just a team player. I'm a rules lawyer. Do you have great weapon fighting?
Yeah.
You would reroll both those twos, right?
No.
Oh, you don't
have great weapon master.
Oh, gotcha, no worries.
Sorry.
Just trying to get my clients every bit of.
It's a noble profession.
People hate lawyers until they're on your side.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. We will fight, and then you need them.
Have you been injured in a combat or encounter?
I went the wrong way on the lean, and that was embarrassing.
No.
Are you getting all the points of damage that you could be getting?
Call Iron Garden Mulligan today.
Make the most of your proficiency bonuses. Why has your DM asked you to roll athletics when it was clearly an acrobatics check? Call us today. We charge $1 million.
I was constantly forgetting to use Hunter's Mark, but with Mulligan and Iyengar's help, now every time I remember who my favorite enemy is.
Incredible. I'm gonna fly another 30 feet up in the air, fully out of spell slots, just going, normally it's over before this long. I'm gonna shoot two Eldritch Blasts at this dude. It's an 18 on the first one. Mm-hmm. Next one is an 11.
Yeah, the 18 hits.
And we'll go ahead, this is gonna be plus 3, 11 points of force damage.
Perfect. He's gonna use his reaction to bring up his shield and half that using a stone shield and then fling it at you. Make a dexterity saving throw.
Yikes! I don't know. That's a nat 20!
Yay! Yay! It flies wide, and as it lands with a thud, maybe you turn back to make a retort, but you realize at this point, almost all of the fight has gone out of him. He sits there kind of ponderously for a moment, almost readying himself to do that submersive thing where he would, pardon my French, wreck your shit, because it's a charge attack and you're all far away enough. But instead, looks up at the booth where the master of ceremonies in a robe rests and says, this is pointless. What is point? Let's them win. You know, there's no point to any of it.
What do you mean?
I shoot up from my dead grave.
It's pointless.
Shut up. We've explained the point, and you are letting the fear of the unknown keep you from fighting. Because you can say it right now in this moment that this is pointless. But when we go back to where we go, and you sit down, and you close your eyes to rest, you will find yourself unable to sleep, because you will lay there wondering what would have happened if you actually tried. So instead of sitting there like a sad sack of sand, get up and fight.
You say this and like a giant spurt of blood comes out of your mouth and down your robes. And he says, what do you mean when you return back to where you came from?
I don't know where you will go after this.
You cannot leave unless you win.
What?
You think if you lose, you just... Why do you think we're here?
I just thought that people...
No, you keep fighting until you win. If you don't win, you don't leave. Why? There is no going home. Like, oh, I tried my best and now I leave. No, the only way out is to win. So what is the point?
Can I insight check him?
Yes.
Oh God,
please be lying, please be lying. Shit. You got us, 15.
As his like giant swirling kind of awakened form comes down into his humanoid or human form, you read on his face that there's no point for him to lie. You just see some of the gruffness and toughness fall away, like the first time you see your dad cry. And in some ways it makes you realize that he is telling the truth.
So he might still be alive. Fine, quit, leave, do whatever you do. I wanna be done.
Layla's eyes are glazed over, shining white. She says, I'll see you next cycle. The architect forfeits the match. Victory goes to Trees Nuts.
I thought it was gonna be more fun as a battle and then got really sad and then her name was still Trees Nuts. That's why you pick a bad name.
It was a bit of a strange choice. I did not question.
Yeah. Econ is still kind of just standing in the same position he was standing in, motionless, learning this knowledge and not realizing.
We did it! We won!
Cecilia won't drop her starry form, and those lightning bolts are still coming down on a regular basis.
I take out a handkerchief and just wipe up Econ's robes where he spit out the blood sort of absentmindedly.
The architect walks almost tiredly across the sand to you, Cestia. And then just places a hand on your shoulder and he says, I'm sorry.
How long have you been here?
You know, I stopped counting. I had a partner and after he passed, I didn't really want to leave anymore. When you don't want to leave, you just lose count.
She puts her hand like on his chest, like reassuringly, even though it like, she's not able to connect with like her emotional side in this form and her hand is incredibly cold. Mm-hmm. And she just kind of nods and lets the call lightning stop and just turns and walks away, muttering, he could still be alive, he might still be here.
Who?
It's not over. A friend. We have to go. What's next? I want to go. Why are we not? Why can we be done?
You notice like the crowd is kind of like quiet. This very seldom happens that there's such a somber end to such a glorious battle. And you see Harpy materialize in the middle of the Rajmadan. And like you see see an ethereal hand behind her, like in her major image, like push her forward and she's like. And that was a battle well fought. victory goes to Trees Nuts. How are you guys feeling after your battle?
Well, I think that it was kind of a close one there. It seemed like we were getting knocked around quite a bit. But we made it out in the end, and that's all that matters.
Fantastic. We're looking forward to the audience polls to determine who was our MVP of the match, because we have a very special prize in store just for them. We'll see you in the next contest. And before her mic is cut, she's like, what the fuck? You can't just, what the fuck is this shit? And you just see her disappear.
Moving on.
It almost seems like just a yawning, ominous, dark tunnel now. A tunnel into the arena stands before you, Cestia.
She leaves immediately.
Yeah. There's a stark contrast to the bright sunlight that you walked into and the dark tunnel you walk into now.
How are you all right?
We won. That's what we wanted, right?
But we can never leave if we don't win the whole thing. So we'll just be stuck here forever?
Well, until you win. And we're kind of the winningest team so far.
If you're stuck here forever, you know, you can find people, you can get married, you can have families. Sometimes it'll be generations of people that grow up after you are trapped here.
But you're from here.
Yeah, my great-grandparents or great-great-grandparents got stuck here, and, you know, it is what it is.
So you've never been to the outside world at all? This is the only thing you've ever known?
Yeah, but, you know, the whole world, the whole multiverse comes here, or at least the people that want to change something that got ruined.
But some of us have responsibilities that we have to go back to. We've got roles.
Like what?
Don't give me attitude. Like, I'm the person who made this rule. Look, you all had something. Look, every one of you wanted to come here and change the past. A deal that nobody gets anywhere at all, ever. And you all thought, I'm magical enough, I'm strong enough. You know, for me, the multiverse should make an exception. That's called hubris. And now you're here in this magical place with all of us who are trapped here.
Yes, that's why it's so easy for you to say. What changes for you if you lose? Nothing. You have no stakes. You have nothing to go back to. I have come to terms with, no matter what happens here, I'll figure it out. But I do not want to be here. You don't even know where you will go, what plane you will appear on, if you even won this.
Yeah, I don't.
What do you want to change?
I come from a tribe of warriors. And as time passes, you fight till you die. And before you die, you take leadership roles, and it is all done through violence and being the strongest. In my age, I was noticing my time was coming up, that eventually a blade would end me, but I wasn't ready to die. So I put down my blade as a barbarian and did something that you can do much longer, and became a wizard. When I returned to my tribe, I was banished as a coward because I didn't want to die by the same blade that I lived by. That was the greatest mistake of my life because I have no tribe. But right now, I don't even have a home. But it makes sense, you know. You know, it's almost kind of funny because this is the perfect hell for me. Someone who ran away from a fight, who is forced to fight for the rest of eternity. He kind of just storms off.
As you storm off, you pass Abaddon, kind of seemingly exhausted, against leaning against the tunnel that you exit from. And he says to you, what is life if not one long battle? I'm sorry, brother, I thought you knew.
It's okay. If I don't make it out this time, I will fight by your side the next cycle.
He puts a forearm towards you again, like he did back in the spa, and he says, I think you can make it. I believe in your strength. And I don't think it's worth much, but while we are here, I will be your tribe.
Thank you. I'm going to go rest.
I'm sorry.
I've sanded.
I'm very sorry. I feel like I came down on you harder than the others.
I wouldn't have had it in
you know, like way. A teacher on a favorite student.
Exactly.
I apologize.
You know, on the battlefield, we are not friends.
Yeah, those bruises on your beautiful pectoral muscles, my heart, it breaks.
No, it's okay. You know, the waters in the mud, you know, they fix it.
I will see you down there. As the two of you exit, Leora comes out and she's like, hi, sorry, I know this is a very somber moment, but we need you to vacate the arena because it needs to switch over for the next match.
Yeah.
Okay.
Regina gets up.
We'll talk and walk.
Walks out, dragging
the claymore. Thank you. As you exit into the tunnel, you see behind you, this is the first time you've lingered this long, that now that the stands are empty, they kind of graduated and chung, 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 close in on each other, forming like this long sort of stone cylinder, and you hear like rock grinding on rock as it starts to like rotate, and the wall, the passage behind you is now closed. And you hear beyond it strange sounds of like birds chirping, and like you even smell sounds as like you realize that as this giant sort of grinder thing is like turning, that it's switching over, preparing for the next contest. Mm.
Who are you trying to find?
I'm not there. Oh, I already went there in a tunnel. I missed all of the reveal.
Are you back in your room?
No, she's going to be just wandering halls screaming a name, looking for
Zaya. People die here? I mean, like, the guy who we fought before, the one with the mask, is he dead?
No.
So you can't die.
Die.
Yeah, you could definitely die, honey. Which is why you guys should probably make your way to the spa. You're so late on your itinerary today, but...
We start...
I try to be understanding.
Walking to the spa.
I mean, you know how it is, Layla. We've got such strict... And I don't think that the master's going to be happy after this one. I think she's going to be, like, very upset. Because that was, like, a downer.
Next one's another group one?
I don't know yet, because, like, not to be rude, but, like, you guys kind of shit the bed back there with that whole, like, really depressing vibe. So usually when things like this happen, like, it's about performance. Like, that's what powers this whole thing, is that raucous cheering and laughter. And if you don't play the game, then they're going to figure out a way to get you out of here earlier, you know? You don't want to end up in the loser bracket, because those are the worst.
Big smiles!
You gotta sell the merch, you gotta sell the fight.
Is it possible to win as a group?
At the end, only one of you will win. It's a bit unprecedented that one of you didn't try back there. I mean, half of your party was having a hard time. I was watching. That was a little rough to watch, but I also assume you guys didn't know the stakes, so. Anyways, she takes her clipboard. She's like, personally, I find it a little offensive that you're like, why would anybody live here? Like, some of us are native, but anyways, like, come along, I guess. It's fine. I would rather die than live in your developing nation type of energy, but you know what? I try not to be judgmental. I try. I think I just need to make me another cup of tea because I'm here again. And I was here. And sometimes I just feel like some of you just know how to push my buttons.
You have buttons.
I'm with you. I'm looking at you because you understand.
Yeah, like, imagine people saying, oh my God, this shithole. Why do you, How do you think we feel?
Yeah, I've
wow.
I don't come to your plane and ask for a second chance on some shit I've messed
exactly.
up.
Yeah, exactly. You get it.
I get it.
Really? I'm going to talk to your sister about this, you know. Her and I are good friends. But anyways, I'll make your dinner arrangements.
Thank you.
Ungrateful cretins. And, you know, I'll arrange for your beds to be turned while you're staying at the Ritz Polo Coat. Let me just make sure. And Layla will fold your towels into swans. But God forbid you end up getting stuck here because, you know, wouldn't that just be the worst? And she's specifically looking at, like, Layla and Nikhil. Yeah.
It's, they just need a minute to...
You're like, too nice. We gotta worry about, like, the big boss, you know? It's our heads on the line here, too.
I do a good job. I'm a good worker. You're not gonna tell the boss that I'm...
Well, you're not
slacking.
You're not gonna tell, are you?
No. I won't tell if you won't tell.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Okay.
Okay.
I wouldn't even know how to tell the boss.
I don't even think you know who the boss is,
Nicole,
because I was your supervisor. You didn't even recognize me.
You're my supervisor?
For like 3 months. We had to move you out of hospitality because we'd send you to go make up a room and you just fall asleep in the bed.
That's what that week was. Okay.
You said, and when I called you out on it, you said, I thought it was on nap duty. Like, that's a freaking thing that you can be
if
on.
You don't test the beds, how do you know they're comfortable?
I don't have enough ladles for this right now. Yeah, whoever talked about spoon theory clearly hasn't met me because I need fucking ladles for the amount of bullshit I have to scoop in any given fucking day.
Why don't you do some self-care? We're gonna head over to the spa. Thank you so much.
Go to your rooms first. I think that Kishar's got a... You've got an itinerary.
Oh.
Did you not get a copy of your itineraries?
No, here. Well, thank
Kishar
you.
Kishar didn't give you one? Oh my God, I'm gonna kill her.
Nikhil's got a pocket full of itineraries. <It's> and yeah, we never got those. I don't know what's going on.
Itinerary, and there's a dinner tonight. Because you've made it to the last bracket. There's a special dinner. I'm assuming you don't know about the...
No.
I'm not gonna cry. Strong women don't cry. They push down their tears and they turn it into fire.
Oh no, strong women can cry. Crying's okay. Admitting to your weaknesses and showing vulnerabilities is the strongest thing a person can do.
It's not, it's magic.
I'm pretty sure that's where magic comes from. It's from choking down your tears and turning them into fire bolts.
No,
that's you get me. True. You get it. That's how you Eldritch Blast. People are like, oh, you gotta study, you gotta sell your soul to like some weirdo from the desert that tells you, oh, hey, guess what? You know what? I'm not gonna get into this right now. You've already heard the story, but you don't remember it. But anyways, moving along. Shush, go. And please, don't doubters, smiles, losers bracket, smiles, 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 smiles.
It's really not so bad when you get to know the place and the people. You can make a good life here and you don't have to fight if you don't want to.
I'm sure had I chosen to do such a thing or known that would be the case, I'm sure it's a lovely place. It is lovely, but there are people waiting for me to come home. There's an ocean that needs to stay in balance.
Oh, that sounds nice.
It is nice when it's maintained.
I suppose it wouldn't be so bad to be stuck here. I don't really have anything to go back to, per se. So... maybe I could be helpful to people here. And like you said, it's nice. I do like the mud bath with the healing powers. That's very nice. Maybe I could learn something from those healing properties to apply to my own studies of medicine and healing and taking care of people. And as you say, there are a lot of people here who are being used against their will by somebody else. Right. I really hate that.
None of it's right. None of this is right for anyone.
It's
all I've ever really known.
What can you tell us about the person who's in charge, the master of ceremonies?
I don't know. I've never met them. I actually honestly don't remember much beyond this cycle. I don't know if there was an accident or something happened, but all I know is that I am here to serve.
Nikhil, what about you?
What?
Nikhil, I'm starting to think that you maybe hit your head sometime because Layla seemed to think that you probably knew each other because you both worked here and you didn't remember your supervisor and you didn't remember that you worked in hospitality.
No, he's just an asshole.
Oh.
Bingo.
Well, that checks out.
You got questions about how this place works?
Yes, well, and about what you remember about being born here.
Yes, you know, the whole place is dominated by the Rajmadan. Mom and Pop used to say that, you know, there were gods of this place, or maybe of many places, but amongst them this place, that crafted the Rajmadan here at the intersection of all these realms. I always kind of thought from how they used to talk about it that probably whoever's at the center of the Colosseum is probably one of those gods. And if you are like me, and the idea of, you know, trying to study this stuff makes you want to cross your eyes and go to sleep, then you're just like, well, I could go talk to these knucklehead scholars in the library, or I could just win the contest and meet the person themselves and say, you know, what's up? This place is weird. Have a good one.
And that's what you're gonna tell them if you win?
Yeah, if I win, I'm gonna walk in, I'm gonna be like, you the guy? And they're gonna be like, yeah. And I'll be like, all right. And then I'm gonna walk out and win again.
And win again? So you would just come back and stay in the cycle even though you would be allowed to leave?
Where would I go?
So why compete? Why stop others from being able to achieve that?
You don't really care about others, do you?
Is everything coming out of your ass?
As you say this, you see Kishar. You've like finally made it to your dorms, and Kishar says, sometimes things go in.
Oh, I'm aware.
To double door,
my girl. Aye.
Two-way street.
Yes.
Exactly. What's up, Kishar? Are we good again?
Palodio.
Here's the thing. Palodio was actually not the fish you saw that was dead in your tank. I accidentally poured vodka into Palodio's tank, and Palodio died earlier, and I replaced Palodio and then forgot to feed the replacement fish.
Damn.
So, but as soon as I find where Palodio Prime is, then they...
I don't think it's even evil, malice. Never loved anyone, so you can't understand.
I'm going to leave. I think Nikhil turns and walks away. Nikhil is not a good guy. And I think, like every sort of selfish narcissist, Nikhil takes. Is able to flawlessly take the consequences of his poor behavior and turn it into perceived persecution.
As he's walking out, I'll shout after him. The only one stopping you from having friends is you. We're all here.
I'm gonna go look for Sestia.
Perfect. Where does he find you?
Oh, Beans. I think she has shouted herself hoarse, stuck in starry form, and is just like crying in a corner somewhere because she couldn't find him.
Yeah, yeah. As you're crying in a corner, you attract a little bit of attention. It's a half elf with smoked out eyeliner. He wears a bright blue tunic with a high collar and rolled up sleeves. His hair falls down to his shoulders in gently cascading waves of amber. He has skin the color of honey. And these waves fall around a face that seems perpetually poised to spring into action, which is what he does the second you collapse. He immediately says, "Oh my gosh, are you okay?"
I'm sorry.
Oh, you're so cold. Let me get you a jacket. And you notice now he is manning a cart full of merchandise. He grabs a jacket with Wizard Daddy written on it. And just puts it around your shoulder. Oh, you're so cold. Are you okay? And he puts both of his hands on your face.
This is a nice jacket. Thank you.
I mean, technically, I think this might count as a sale, and it'll go towards my quota. I'm only 23 away.
Okay. I don't have money because I'm in a sort of transcendent starry form, right? But thank you.
Are you all right? Do you need help?
Oh, God, you're very nice, and I don't know how to tell you yes, but I don't think you can help me. I'm looking for a friend, and I just learned what all of this is about.
What all of what is about? Also, hi, I'm Bailey Moss. How's it going?
Bailey? Hi, I'm Cestia.
Hi, Cestia. That's a pretty name. You must be like here from someplace else. I've never heard that name.
Thank you. Focus. And I think she kind of like just sort of slowly removes herself from his grip and pushes herself up to standing. But she like pulls the jacket around herself a little more.
You notice now that like on both sleeves there's like a image of like that fist that you've seen Econ conjure. Yeah, and right here on the breast is like Econ in an expression you've never even seen him make. It's like,
oh, shit. That doesn't feel on brand for. Wait, hold on. I'm sorry. I'm having a very big emotional moment, and I'm sort of losing the. Is there anything of me on this cart?
There is a foam finger. And it has like, it's like in the form of like a gun, like a finger gun.
Yeah.
There's two of them, a right and a left, and when you put them together, it looks like a bow being drawn, like an arcane bow. It's got constellations on it.
I'm like, I'm just gonna help your quota, and I do just slowly grab them and tuck them under my arm.
Pretty great, that was my design.
Huh?
Are you buying?
Yeah.
What are you buying? What are you selling? What do you got?
Well, look.
What do you got?
If you help me get back to my room, I have money I can pay for.
Of course, I mean, it's on the house. Nice. Really, I just have to push the product. Money doesn't really have meaning here, you know.
Yeah, why are you? Were you born here too? Do you know Tavayu?
Tavayu. You know, honestly, this place is so big. It's so many people come and go. Yeah. But I also know a lot of people. Okay. So maybe I could help you.
Well, if you see.
And then his eyes dart over your shoulder and he sees Nicole and he's like, oh shit.
Lances, I'm supposed to be signing those.
Hey.
Well, yes, no, maybe so?
Yes.
Okay. Don't fuck me on my commission on those signed lances.
Okay. He like looks at you, he's like, he's so mean to me.
I'm sorry. Thank you. I appreciate
Ever
it.
Ever since like I got here. Like one time he put my hand in warm water and thought I would pee, and then I didn't. So then he just put it in boiling water.
It's called science, and you experiment, okay?
I had like third degree burns on my hand for like a week.
Oh my God, I'm sorry I didn't, that's how I found out other people burn when hot stuff touches them. Mm-hmm. Not everyone's experience is the same.
Your only reaction was, well, clearly it didn't work, you still didn't pee.
Thank you so much for your help, Bailey.
I'll look into your thing for you. And if you need any merch, you know, I got everything here.
Thanks.
You know, I got all the fixins.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, I even have snacks. I got dried seaweed.
She just turns away Mardina and kind of looks at Nicole. Can we go back?
Yeah.
Thanks.
You looking for the room?
Yeah.
Probably should stop by the spa first because I don't know when our next match is going to be. Okay.
Are you okay?
Hell yeah, I didn't even get fucking touched. This armor is awesome. That goblin hooked my ass up. I love... Or Oliver? Oliver?
He's great. Be. That is not
Look.
The name.
I'm not great at this kind of stuff.
Yeah. Do your best.
You were screaming a name of a person I've never heard of before.
That doesn't mean much.
Doesn't mean much.
Yeah.
Look, people suck for the most part. You, I don't know if you suck or not, but you haven't done anything thus far. And normally by this point, people do something that indicates that they suck. You have not. So.
Thank you.
Do you? You've helped me in situations where you didn't have to. I think that's wild and ill-advised. But for some reason, when
she just hugs you and starts to cry again.
Aww. I return the embrace, confused.
You feel a handkerchief come over your shoulder.
What the hell?
And it has like an elephant's head embroidered on it.
Aww.
It's Bailey's.
Hey. You got your face is full of water.
You're very bad at this, but thank you for trying.
Look, most people that are able to get to this place are very powerful. Most powerful people are bad. Most of the people that come here to change stuff, the stuff they're trying to change probably shouldn't be changed. The whole name of the game in this place is dodging consequences. And I don't like that. But there's something about you that makes me think you're not trying to clean up your own fuck up. I'm rarely right about these things. But am I wrong this time?
I made a mistake letting a friend come here alone. And if I could change anything, I would go back and undo it. But if he's gone, he's gone. But if he's here, if I win, everyone else stays. There's no good answer. This place is wrong. So I'm not crying because I'm frustrated by not knowing the rules before I got here, but trying to figure out if there's a win condition. And I don't think there is. So what do we do? Just keep fighting? Why?
The last time I ever fought in one of these things, which was the last time I was ever hanging out with Outworlders this much, I was a kid. I was way worse at fighting. No one really talked to me. And this is the first time I've been with people that ask why about anything. You know, Merdina and the other squad, the other half of Tree's Nuts.
They're nice and not that good at fighting. So what do we do? Are we supposed to kill them at some point? I'm not gonna kill them. That's insane.
Okay, so they're nice or whatever. They came to a coliseum at the center of the cosmos. To fix something they could have fixed by staying home. You're telling me there's no way to fix whatever problem? Okay, so Merdina's got the pH balance of her ocean all out of whack. Fucking go to the store and get some shit to make the ocean better. Wizard Daddy has a problem with his tribe. Do we think his tribe was wrong or that he didn't know the rules of his tribe in his world? And Layla has a great game folding towels. She loves that shit, I think. So, and the fucking Lenore looked me dead in the eyes and said, maybe it's not that bad to stay here. People that have a good deal back on their world don't say shit like that. Not everybody who comes here has the most heroic impulse in mind. And even if they do, they're looking for an easy way out. Some wish at the center of the cosmos in a coliseum built around bloodshed. You had a harder way available to you to fix this on your world with your people, and you came here. So I don't have a lot of patience for Outworlders. I think it would be kind of funny to win this contest every single fucking time and shut it down from the inside.
That's it.
What?
Let's win and shut it down. The people that made mistakes come in here. Okay, maybe they were not great, but they don't deserve to be locked in this. You were born into this. Just because you're whoever made a mistake doesn't mean you or your sister with the really cute top deserves it.
Yeah.
No one deserves this, so let's break it. Let's just fucking break it.
And with that, we're gonna take a break.
Yeah! Nice. Fuck this game!
Welcome back. After this somber discovery, the atmosphere in the hero's repose is not quite the raucous laughter that we're used to. And somewhere else in the dormitory compound, we do find Cestia and Nikhil consoling each other. After you make this sort of pact or resolution between each other, what do you do?
Should we go back?
No, spa. Let's get rested. We could be fighting again in a second.
It never stops. Okay.
Yeah.
Don't punch the tree this time. Do you know how much it must suck to be a tree?
Yeah, it's gotta suck to be a tree.
All the time, with just bugs in you?
Yeah. You can't move, you can never leave.
Yeah.
Just trapped. Trapped forever.
Oh, hey buddy, you want a foam finger?
We're number one, let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
You need to sign the lances.
What?
The lance keychains?
This is gonna take just as... Keychains? I heard foam lances!
Well, that was before the last battle.
Whoa.
I got downgraded to keychains?
But you know what we do have? We have a free crown. A crown architect. Like, the architect's crown. Full size replica. He puts it on your head. It looks great. It even fits your horns. It's a whole thing. I love it. You want to buy something? What are you buying?
Wait, he quit the fight and he gets a whole crown?
I mean, like, but come on. The way he just... like, punched Wizard Daddy into the ground, the women were swooning. They wanted to see these two bears fight forever, you know? That was great for the ratings, I think.
Look, we all want to see bears get down and dirty with each other. But at the end, yes! But at the end of the day, I believe one team emerged victorious, and that's tree's nuts! And I'm going to throw the crown. I'll see you in the spa. You know, have fun selling those unsigned keychains after this next match.
Do you want a commemorative ornament?
Yes! And
it's a tree And it says on it, tree's nuts. And it's the tree that you fought earlier.
With I already smashed it because I saw a tree. I'm all over the place.
With acorns hanging from it. And each acorn is one of your names.
Oh my God.
Can I have one that I promise I won't break it?
I don't know. He just, I trust you.
Thank you.
They're great for holiday presents.
Do you guys have holidays here?
No.
Of course we do.
We do?
You don't show up
to any
of them.
You are so bad. Come on.
Oh my God. Okay, yeah, I'm bad. Let's go to the spa.
Upstairs, what do you all do? Do you also decide to heal your wounds in the spa?
Yes.
I'm sure Econ needs a bit of a break.
Already.
And yes. Spa for sure.
Also going to the spa. Our party enjoys the benefits of a long rest in the healing muds of the clay bath.
Woody muds. Woody muds.
Layla is fish, harmless fish out of Eldritch blast lights, animating them in little mini ponds.
I'm just sort of idly poking at the Eldritch light fish, thinking about my life and all my choices.
Kind of upsets me, but I'll let it happen.
I guess it's not quite as good as real fish.
Oh, it's nowhere near as good as near real fish.
Oh.
It's beautiful, amazing. I can't do that. But real fish, it really is not a comparison.
Well, sure, I've never really seen real fish.
Well,
so
it's
only a close facsimile to what I imagine.
I'm sorry, you're right. I was insensitive. You've never left. I suppose a little quiet. I don't think I can speak to these ones, right?
Oh, no. They don't really do anything except look pretty.
And they do look very pretty.
Hey.
What are you going to do when you get out?
When I get out?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I suppose if I do get my wish, then I don't know. The thing I'm trying to undo, I think it might have made me who I am. So if I change it, then so much will have changed that I don't really know what I'd be walking into. Which is why I think maybe it's not so bad if I don't get out of here. You see, it seems like lots of other people have things that they need to go back for. And if I undid the thing that I wanted to undo, I think maybe that the huge changes that it would have on the course of my life would have bigger repercussions for the universe at large.
Yeah, butterfly effect. So that means you're gonna wanna stay here with me?
I don't know.
Not so bad. And you see Kashar come in with like a bunch of towels under her arm. Kind of left me to do your job. It's okay.
Is it okay?
Yeah.
Good.
I am not one for lying for comedic effect. Sarcasm. My fault's not as deadly.
That's a good thing. We wouldn't want to get killed by towels.
Not now. Headache. Cannot handle.
Okay. At least I'd be seeing more of you around.
There is so much more of me to see.
Noted.
Inches upon inches.
I'm sure there is.
Dinner time.
I'm hungry.
God damn it, Josephine.
Okay, so I think that this situation is, no matter which of us wins, it will change all of our fates, because technically, whoever wins and changes their past doesn't come, which means they're not on our team, and for what it's worth, one of us winning means that we all get what we want, or none of us get what we want. Changes everything.
Can you join at this point?
Definitely.
Hey, you've been crying?
No.
Lies, just a lie.
No, not at all.
I'm good.
Thank you.
Are you lying to me?
I'm gonna intercede and go, I was crying.
I don't believe that.
I'm so proud of you.
You wanna roll about it?
I can't, yeah.
I just give him a little pat on the shoulder as he like defends it. I'm casting guidance.
17.
Even with guidance, I can't beat it.
Oh,
bummer. Yeah, I'm crying because I'm a sucker and I let my feelings get the better of me all the time.
That's so sweet of you to lie for your friend. Maybe you do. Maybe you do think about other people occasionally.
Look, I know this is your first time in Polakos, okay? But running around and telling people how they behave and who they lie for, or whatever the first half of what you said was, doesn't fly here, okay? Take it from a local.
Nikhil, did you hit your head at some point?
Did I hit my head? I don't know. Did anyone see my head get hit out in that fight? Or was I dodging everything out there?
Well, I just mean at some point where you've lost all your short-term memory because you very recently had a conversation with Layla about the fact that she is also an employee of this particular realm.
Both employees of this
no,
realm?
No, just Layla. I'm
you said you're both employees.
It's okay.
I said you're both employees.
Who's both?
You.
I work here?
Yes.
Wow.
I really do think he...
It's okay. I'm not...
Knocked his head around a little.
...particularly memorable.
That's not true.
That way.
Definitely not true.
You're great.
That's good to have you two join us, though.
Yeah. Thanks. I'm sorry if it was weird when I.
No.
Apologize.
Everything's weird. Don't apologize.
It's a lot to take in.
Well, what do we do now?
Dinner. I've said 3 times.
We have dinner. We have itinerary.
Hi.
How are you?
This group is a very tough group to wrangle.
I'm so sorry.
I got yelled at by Leora. A lot. So small, so angry.
She's really angry. You just give her some tea.
Maybe 10 pounds of kick-ass in a 1/2-pound bag.
Yeah. A Ziploc bag full of rage.
It's refreshing, though.
Yeah. I try to give her some tea every now and then. See
she does really like your tea.
I'm sorry. Is there, like, a schedule somewhere we would know where we're supposed to be?
She looks at Nikhil and she's like, leaf of paper with
a book.
Times.
What?
I gave you I gave him the itineraries.
I'll go get it.
I'm gonna go wander in the locker rooms, find the sheets.
Does she find them?
Yeah, they're just in a packet, all crumpled up, and there's some barbecue sauce on one of them.
When did?
Oh, they got ribs here.
We need to go to dinner, y'all. Please.
I'm hungry.
And yes, there's good food.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Kishara leads you all up to the dining hall. It's placed at the top of one of the spires of this place. Mm. So you go up like another spiral staircase, one that goes up now instead of down. And at the top of it, you enter a beautiful circular stone building. There are large, almost like pieces of metal jutting from the ground itself as though they were placed there when the foundation was poured. And these very beautiful geometrical shapes are your tables. And then right on each side of them is the benches. They're lined up and in the middle is a fire genasi who is heating up pots and pans and woks with insane speed. You see a large spit, and sure enough, Nikhil is right. You do not know what animal this is, but there is a giant rack of ribs being rotated, and being like, with great expeditiousness, with one hand he's flipping some chili peppers and onions in a skillet, and with the other one, with beautiful brush strokes, very quickly like putting glaze and sauce on the ribs as he rotates them.
Is there a line? What do we do? I'm just gonna walk up.
Yeah.
You do see some other competitors kind of scattered throughout the cafeteria. There's not many of them. It seems like you're late. But there are people like wrapping up their meal.
Oh no.
But there isn't a line. In between these tables, there's like these almost channels or pathways leading to the center where the kitchen is. Yeah.
There is a saying where I come from, for ribs that big. I'm going to try and remember it. Yaba, daba, go.
Yabadabadoo.
Yeah. Layla grabs a plate and just starts tearing into it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's standing there carving off slices of meat. He seems like kind of like distracted or half there, and he's like, "What can I get you?"
As much as you'll spare. are you all right?
What the fuck do you want to eat?
All of it, anything.
With one hand, he takes the entire rack of ribs and puts it on your plate. Make a strength saving throw.
9 total.
Yeah, he does it with such dexterity and force, kind of using the weight of the ribs, that the entire tray clatters to the ground.
Oh no!
It's good off the floor.
Yeah, I don't mind.
Floor ribs is perfectly fine.
Yes, yes, don't be afraid. You know, I had a friend back home where one time a rib was so big when it went on the side of his cart, the cart tipped over.
How humorous.
Yes, he was wild.
That's incredible. I will eat up. Then.
I just sit down, crisscross applesauce in front of the floor ribs.
Yep.
Can I have some belly?
And his eyes like fixate on you. And he says, "I don't serve her, and I don't serve anyone with her."
Well, that isn't very nice.
I'm so sorry. What's
roll initiative.
Okay.
Oh my god.
What?
God.
Shit.
God. I'm about to have a food fight.
Damn.
6. You got one.
12.
Oh, 12.
Oh, it's a 19 for me.
And 8. Yeah. An 8 over here.
Of course. 5 for Sestia, because I'm mid
range. Yeah, I got a 6.
Yeah. We're eating.
Yeah.
Mine is a 1. Not a natural 1. I have 2, but I have negative 1. So now it is a 1.
I'm looking at it, and I don't believe it.
It's truly amazing.
I'm so happy.
Wow. Abysmal.
You see the flames on him ignite in a way that they were not dancing before. Where his hair was once like kind of cropped short, it suddenly becomes very long and flowy behind him. The molten sort of pieces of armor on his very lithe, muscular body, like almost glow with this sort of molten light as they kind of become warm or become heated again. And you see like the flame kind of in his eyes flick out in a beautiful like winged eyeliner, because he's fabulous. He gets to go first. I don't know if he would hit your mouthy self first or the person he hates. I'm gonna say the person he hates. Okay, so I've got a 19 to hit you, Layla. And then a 19 for a follow-up. With anger, like he says, like ignoring this person he doesn't know, and he says, "You could at least give me peace in my own domain." And he hits you twice. Once with a headbutt and then with a leg sweep.
Oh,
he swept the leg.
You take 14 bludgeoning damage as he strikes you. And then as he does, you see his fists ignite. And you take an additional 9 fire damage. And then he like strikes a pose and does the whole like.
Oh no.
You're in my house now.
Hi, I'm Layla!
And the hellish rebuke.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, I'm Layla. The yep. Hellish Rebuke is pretty great.
Right? Yeah. At least you introduced yourself.
Yeah. Yeah, you tried.
18.
Woo!
Do I roll a dex save?
Do you roll a dex yes. save?
Yes. Yes. I roll a dex 12.
Does not make it.
Yeah. I have legendary resistance.
Ah.
So I succeed.
Whoa!
Half as much damage, so nine damage.
Nine, and then that's halved again.
Successful. So, although it is fire damage.
I was going to say, so it's halved again.
It's halved again. Ah!
Oh, no!
Nikhil, you see this go down. What do you do? I would say you've seen Philindar before.
Philindar?
Yeah. And you're not used to this, like, kind of... This isn't how he usually acts. He's usually like, sup, bro?
Yeah. I'm going to... Listen... This could, I know this is not advantageous, but we're not in the arena right now. Mm-hmm. I don't think Nikhil knows that he's in initiative. So I think he's holding, yes. a rib and he looks up and he's like, hey man, what's up? And I'll continue to eat these ribs.
Layla, this is what you hear.
What's going on?
I don't know. Do I know you? What?
I don't care if you fight back. It won't stop me.
I'm not gonna fight back.
Layla, did you sleep with him? Because we get a lot of that energy with
him. I don't know how to sex.
Huh? What?
I don't know how to sex.
Can I insight check that?
That's a bigger problem.
It's 17. Do you really not know how to
sex? I have a Yuga, so she is pure as the driven snow.
I dropped my rib.
Can I make an insight check soon? Okay. 17 minus 2 is 15.
I don't even know where you put it.
What's the 8 you're referring to?
I don't even know that.
As this conversation's happening, Merdina, do you just keep eating your ribs?
Yes, this is engaging. I'm glued to the conversation here.
Lenore?
I think this is all just a horrible misunderstanding. I'm going to cast Fast Friends. Mm-hmm. So you need to succeed a wisdom saving throw.
21.
God damn it.
I think you are a fool. And your head is as empty as your smiles.
Would you just... Say it out loud.
You don't know what a friend is. You're one of those people that's like fake nice because there's no kindness inside you. Next.
Gosh. Well, it's me? Okay. this rib is, it's double floored now.
You will be spared my ire.
Oh my God, thank you. But
you should have sat there and ate your food.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep eating, but I do just want to know, like, let's put it this way. If there's a problem here, and I don't know why. What? Just let me know what's happening here, and maybe I help you defeat her.
Roll persuasion.
A dirty 20.
Oh!
With a bite at the end to send it home.
This wench is the one who bound me here in this servitude. She's the reason I'm here. A noble warrior like me firing up walks, and that's why this walk is gonna be driven through her worthless head.
I want to drop, if I can still do things, I want to drop the delicious, delicious rib and like crawl over to him and get really close, even if it's like hot there.
Yeah, he doesn't burn you. It's like sitting by like a fireplace.
Aww. Sweet. Well, I don't know, I'm walking up to like open burners.
As you're like crawling over there, you do notice like he has like, actually, roll perception. You're very close now.
Sweet. Come on, that's pretty good. Okay, a dirty 20 again.
Wow.
Yeah, nice. as you're calling over, and this is how I imagine in my head, correct me if I'm wrong, you like look up and you notice like he's wearing like almost like tabby shoes or like monk's shoes.
Yeah.
And like these beautifully like billowing pants, and he has like the stance of a martial warrior.
Oh. Yeah.
And you see in his face with that perception check, like pain, anger, and insult.
Yeah, I go in and I get as close as I can because I want to whisper this because I don't know how the rest of the group is feeling. But just, what if we, I don't want to be bound here and I don't know what she did and this whole system is really fucked up, but what if we break it? What if we stop it? Would you help us? Or just don't stop us, please don't. If you tell now and we go to the loser's bracket, it's all over, but this is maybe a chance. I see you. You're a monk, not a very good cook. You can be both. You can contain multitudes, but you're more than this. If this is a thing we can fix, please help us try.
God damn it, Abri, this is gonna be a really cool fight.
I'm sorry. You can punch me. You can punch her.
Can we just please Photoshop in the art here and just like.
One shot kill, baby.
Yeah.
There was gonna be like molten, he's gonna heat metal. And he was this really cool fire genasi monk that was gonna be like, boom, boom, boom. And like, he was legendary. And he was gonna like beat the ever living crap out of you guys.
He made ribs too good. I can't fight that.
If my spell had succeeded, I was just gonna have him keep cooking.
That's worse. He looks down at you on the floor.
I'm sorry, I should be standing. This is weird.
And he sees sincerity in your eyes. He sees you've been crying.
Why is everyone aware of me? Golly, I gotta drop the star for
you. It's your mascara, it's running.
Yeah, that's fair.
It's beautiful though. It's glittery and gorgeous.
Thank you.
Why are you here with her?
Please. We just got thrown together and I'm not saying that anything that happened between the two of you.
I do not know her relation to the creators of this place, but this is a being of pure evil.
I fold towels.
Hey, she's not.
Do not lie to me or I will drive my fist through your teeth.
I would never lie to you.
The same teeth you lie through, I will break.
I'm not good at lying.
Roll deception.
17.
Oh man, monks are so wise.
I want to roll. I would have wanted to try to cast guidance on him to see the sincerity because I think she's telling the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So like you're helping him?
Yeah, I literally would like grab his shoe. Mm-hmm. I'm down on the ground and just pat him on the foot.
Yeah, go ahead and roll for his guidance.
4.
So that's a 26. He looks at you and he says, yeah, are you lying?
No.
He says, I know you're...
think so.
No, you're not lying. Then this is a cruel trick.
How could I be playing a trick if I was not lying?
Your face. That face.
Philidor, I'm just gonna lean in and say, when we're not in
what's there. Up, homie? How's it going?
That's good, man. What's up? I know that you're...
You need to hook you up with another jar of the rib sauce?
The rib sauce would be great. I know you're holding it down back here in the kitchen. When we're not on the gladiators field, there's a whole gendered element to you talking about hitting a lying woman in the teeth that I just want you to consider in this
right here. Please don't do that.
No, and I'm just... scooch no, back. Not you. To
no, I know.
Lila, I'm just saying. Just like... I would just say, like, Freya, just Freya, you know, if you want to challenge someone to a duel, that's one thing, but you're like, you're a liar, and I'm going to knock your fucking teeth out. It's just like, yikes!
Well, that's because I see women as equals. If I can knock your teeth out, why can't I knock a woman's teeth out?
Yeah, thank you. What? I don't know what side of this.
Wait, what are you, where are you?
I just reach for a little squeeze bottle of rib sauce and then crawl back.
Yeah, we'll take the rib
you
sauce.
Don't know what she is.
Who is she?
Yeah, tell us.
Yeah, what?
Who am I?
What?
What?
I told you, I don't really remember much past this previous cycle.
So you don't remember anything about what was happening before we got here?
No.
So you just woke up in a corner folding towels one day.
So after the elephant woman hit you on the head, you've forgotten all
of Cerebel?
Yeah, Cerebel.
To remember her name, she's kind of cool.
I mean,
I put a lot of love.
She is kind of cool, actually.
She's a cool war elephant with a hundred more names. Maybe I remember her name.
I remember vague things, like I know Olin and
that I am here to serve.
What?
But you don't have any idea how long you've been here for.
Who do you know her as?
Yes.
I don't know exactly the connection, but I know she's connected to the Master of Ceremonies.
Oh. You're a cleric, right?
Mm-hmm.
Lenore, do you have a deity you worship or a faith you belong to where you get your spells from?
Of course.
Okay. How about you?
The creator.
The creator?
Of the arena.
Can you...
The god of the games.
Call upon your deity to...
I don't hear anything back. I'm not that important.
No, but I just
get the spells. What, do you hear something?
I mean, like,
vaguely. Your god talks to you?
Well, I think so. I sometimes hear voices in my head, and I just assume that it's my god talking to me.
Oh.
But you can't call upon your god to imbue you with power beyond just, like, getting your spells? You don't have any sort of deeper connection or understanding?
I don't really have any connections. What? Why are you here?
Yes, what is it that binds you to the place that you're in?
It's easier to show you. Follow me. I think my shift's over anyway.
Yeah, I was gonna say the binding's pretty, like, you know, it's like a binding from like, it's like 9 to 5. Binding, yeah.
It's kind of complicated. It's like a whole thing.
The shackles of
gap. Yeah. It's like a grabbing whatever, like, loose meats are in this area.
There's a lot. There's kebabs, there's tandoori chicken. Basically, everything's barbecued. Ooh. Not a lot of vegetarian options. There's some, though.
But you just put it in my arms and I'll carry you feed.
Look, we don't have to. And I get, as I'm getting into her arms, like, we don't have to do this.
And follow. And he leads you down the stairs to, like, through some of the dark halls to a sort of, like, crossroads that has, like, these little signs on it, different angles. He leads you in the direction of the one that says VOV.
Oh,
Festival of Valor. He leads you to this sort of doorway that, like, tapers at the top. Inside, you see glistening sandstone, shined with a devotion you would find exhausting. There are glass cases, crystal plants, and alcoves containing weapons, relics, items of clothing. And from their inscriptions and from their descriptions, you realize they are mementos from heroes of the past. There are a few statues and busts of warriors as well, all winners, even if the only thing they won over was the audience. Mm. And it's actually what Philandar says to you. Like, he says that everyone here was victorious in their own way, whether they won the hearts, the minds, or of those that beheld them, or whether they won the competition. He actually takes an arm and, like, gestures towards a few of the statues that are scattered in one corner of this, like, kind of rectangular room. There's a human woman with cropped hair holding aloft a golden skull with a candle on top. The skull is, like, actually gold, but the rest is plaster. Her robes kind of flow behind her, like as though she's like actively spellcasting. And in front of her, like there's endless like tentacles that are issuing forth like from the ground, and all of this is like taking up a corner of this room. He points out another one, a small goblin. She's in an adorned skirt with a small fitted blouse and a sash tied around her exposed midriff. Her hair is pulled back into a French braid, and she's holding aloft a lantern. And the lantern is lit, and it's casting beautiful, like, stained glass patterns on this half of the hall. And then he gestures to a fire genasi in a roundhouse kick pose, his eyes furrowed and his brows kind of coming to life. And you see, as the foot that is in the air is on fire, there's like an arc of fire kind of igniting. As you realize, like, you know, he hits the ground with so much force, he creates fire with the friction. And he sits down in front of it like this. You realize it's a one-to-one.
That's your dad. That's crazy.
No, that's him.
What?
That's him.
Look. They made a statue of the cook?
No. I think he was something else before he was a cook, just based on that statue, which seems very menacing. It looks like you were a very, very great warrior indeed.
It looks like you have won.
Right.
And you ended up back here somehow.
That was what I asked for.
What, to stay here?
I said I wanted to feed the hungry. That's what you don't get. There's nothing you can ask for that they won't twist somehow. So they gave me my wish. Now I feed the hungry.
But where does Layla come in?
She was in the commentator's box, that box with that horrible fucking entity who resides over this. She was in the box.
With Harpy? Harpy's not that bad.
Stop lying to me! You can lie to them, but you can't lie to me!
I would never.
I won! I slew you! I won!
I want to back away from this. What? Going over to the goblin piece, do I recognize the person?
No.
Okay. I just wanted to double check.
You were trying to double check if it was Leora?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just like, hold on.
Yeah. Is the goblin Olamon or no?
No.
Look, we know two goblins. We've got to double check. Yes.
Gosh, but not all goblins look the same.
Plaster can be confusing to see.
I got you. Yeah. Right. Looks very vacant and weird too. Yeah.
That's unfair.
I would never lie to you.
I don't think that you would. But I also don't think you remember.
Yes.
And if you can't remember, then you can't really know if you're not lying.
Well, but that's not me. Whatever you knew me as, like, I'm a different person now.
Are you?
Yes! I have memories of the things that I've done with these people, And I have an identity, and I have things that
you're
I want.
You are a shell. You are a tool. You are a puppet. You sit there from your ivory tower, clapping through an empty smile and empty eyes.
You work with them.
And his eyes feel like they pierce you. There's no reason that anyone comes here for a good and noble cause. Most of the people come here for horrible, horrible fucking shit. But I came here because we were suffering from a famine. And they still fucked me. So it doesn't matter what's in your heart. It doesn't matter what you want. There's no wish you can ask them that they won't pervert, that she and her masters won't pervert. Except for you, bro, because we're like indigenous, though. We got to get into an indigenous huddle and figure this out a little bit, you know?
I'm telling you right now, man, this place fucking blows, and that's why you don't go in there with a wish at all. Two things.
So, lay it on me.
Number one.
First of all, what are you eating? Because I'm noticing the gains.
Hey man, you would know, because honestly, that barbecue.
Is this all me?
Well, dude, what honestly happened is I started, well, first of all,
I'm not doing anything. I just wake up like this. Number two, I eat waffles every single morning.
Again, I know, I make them.
You know what it is, actually? Because you would know, because you're fire genasi. I think my metabolism just runs way hot.
We are not focusing on your thing right now. We're always
we
focusing
don't know
on your
where
thing.
Your loyalties lie. Maybe you can't walk trust away.
Her. You can't trust her. I saw truth in your eyes. I have a really good sense for these things. You can't trust her, and you shouldn't trust her.
Do you even want to change anything? So. You're ready to go along with it.
Yeah, I don't need to change anything. I have my little scenes, and I have you guys, and...
For how long?
Everyone, just stop. There's been so much blame. Blaming this, blaming that. And yes, to inherently want to go back and change your past, there is selfishness in that. But just because you want to do something for yourself does not make you bad. Just because you are choosing to change one thing, that is a gift. But now we know that gift is a lie.
That's what I'm saying. You know, like, they're evil, right? They have to be.
Yes.
This has to be some type of cruel joke.
But they...
They do it for... I don't know why they do it.
What do they get out of it?
How would I know that? I'm in the kitchen, and I won!
The magic. Right. The magic that fuels this whole place. It's a cycle.
Yes,
it's less a cycle.
We are...
And more of like a weird linear progression of just the same thing happening over and over again.
But it's exponential.
Like that song by that bard.
You're just flattening a cycle. It's kind of...
Well, if you combine a line and a circle, it's a spiral, right?
Here's what's going on. We are all cogs in this machine. Ever since I first heard it, I see it. They need warriors to generate something that they're getting from the audience. Obviously, it's not money. Money has no value here. Whatever our performance gains them, they need. Now, I don't care where you've come from, we've all heard a version of this game. This is a trick as old as time. And tricks can be flipped.
This place runs on applause. Didn't somebody say that it runs on applause, on the feedback from the audience?
Guys, here's the thing. I would love to talk about this, and I have some ideas, but I don't trust you, Layla.
Well, I do.
There must be some reason that you were kicked out of that commentator box and made to serve. I do realize that it's possible that she was sent to spy on us, but I believe that she is telling the truth to the best of her knowledge.
But that doesn't mean that she might not become something else that we have to face down against soon.
Here is the thing. When I came here, I don't know what happened, but I saw someone who was broken and convinced that they must serve. And that's the first thing I saw when I met. First thing I saw when I met Chutri were people who were so concerned with themselves and having sex with each other in the room. So I'm not gonna sit here and let you judge Layla. When you ran off to go over whatever plan you came up with without consulting the rest of us, and you wanna point fingers? Can't believe you.
How did you get here, Cestia?
There are texts written about this place. I had a friend that came looking for an easy answer to a problem. I followed the path. I thought...
What problem? See, this part's important, right?
For him, he's human. He ages faster than I do, and he was worried that we wouldn't have a lot of time.
Yeah.
I didn't come with him.
Another old trick.
funny.
Wait, did he ask for... What was his name?
Tavayo.
I knew him. He won the competition after me.
But you didn't get to leave?
He asked to live forever.
Do you know where he is?
What's more immortal than a legend?
I think her feet just give out under her.
She's... He, with his monk speed, catches you.
Oh, God. I hate this place.
He was a good friend.
So where is
Would you like to go see him?
I'm sorry. I'm not gonna walk away again.
No. If you walked away now, I would understand. I think we've all learned a lot. There's a lot of mistrust. There's a lot of unknowns. But if we want to make it out of here, I think we're going to have to think long and hard about what our next move is.
I'm sorry to say, friends, I won't be helping you. I'm not feeding any more people into that meat grinder. I do wish you best of luck, though, bro.
You got it.
Natives never won, so you know, you never know. Maybe, like, it's different.
Here's my question. If that statue is you, and you're here.
They don't turn the winners into statues, dude. They just... They commemorate them, okay. Right? Like, what part of that... Come on, bro.
You are so pretty.
Thank you. That's really nice. Everything here in the Raj Madan is always the same. I don't pay a lot of attention.
But that's clear.
For sure. But the past day, almost everything that's happened has felt new. And I don't know if that's bad or if that's good, but it's different. And if the thing that's always been the same has been bad, then doesn't different kind of... No, I didn't get there.
I was following you for a beat.
Yeah, you know what I mean. There's something there. I'll come back to it.
What can you tell me about this leader of the games, master of the games?
My sister would know. Mm. My sister knows everything. And if you've lost all your memories, Lila,
speaking of she kind of like. Her and I were gonna have a thing. She kind of stood me up. Do you know anything about that?
Hey man, that's like, on you, dude.
Yes, on me, bro. You said you were gonna put in a good word.
I put in lots of good words, man. You got to close on your own, dude. I don't know what to tell you. It is what it is.
How many times have I like wingman for you and shit, man?
I need a way though. For the exactly.
No, you really like literally. You do though, like right? Like I thought we had like a code where you were gonna like help me out there. And
he does have wings, so he would need a man God. Take care of his wings.
That?
I took care of your wings, bro.
Look, I'll talk to her and say, hey, Philidar, you remember that guy, Philidar, who's constantly...
Philindar.
Sorry. The fact that I was close, you gotta know how...
I know, bro. You, like, forget. I know it's not personal at this point, you know what I mean? Like,
it's not personal. My sister would
master
have...
Master of ceremonies is an aspect of the god.
What? Actually.
Right? But like, it's never the same.
I want to get a re... I want to zero in on the magic of this place, so I'd like to cast Detect Magic. Mm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, go for it.
Mm. Yeah, that's a good call.
I know there's not a role associated, but I would like to cast Guidance.
Yeah.
I'd also like to give the help action. I'm not smart, but I can cast Divine Sense as well. I can use Divine Sense for sure. Yeah.
So, he crosses his legs and he tries to get in tune with the magic in this place and his eyes go white.
Give me an Arcana check with the guidance. And how are you helping?
Oh, just the help action. I'm using Divine Sense for flavor, but it's just the help action.
Oh, okay. And then with advantage, okay. Yes.
You can roll the d4 for guidance if you want. Mm.
Oh, 26.
Dang.
Can you add the d4?
Oh, then let me roll the d4.
It could be a 30. Oh, it could be a 30.
Come on. 30.
Come on, 30.
30.
Oh, wait, hold on. Let's make this extra good. I use wheel.
What is wheel?
Take another 5 on top of that.
So that is 27, and then, so yeah, that's gonna be 32.
As you sit and meditate, it's almost like the material world around you turns into like a, almost like a 3D grid made of stars. And because the walls around you become transparent in your meditation, you see Polarcote in its entirety. And realize that a lot of what this place is the material plane, not formed of magic at all. You see homes, you see all of these. It's almost as though your consciousness leaves your body and kind of floats. And you behold all of this. And this sort of transparent form of the Colosseum, you see as illusory magic as well as transmutation magic. But there is some like actual brick and stuff there, but
flavor. Yeah. Mm. So it's as we expect. Okay. Seems like this, you know, obviously, I mean to you, but I mean in the general, since this place is real and there's some transmutation magic in the arena. Mm-hmm. Obviously for the different kind of battlegrounds, but.
Sestia, did you want to come here with your wish to change how you treated your friend or to find him?
I didn't know he was still alive. I wanted to go back to that moment. And even if it meant coming here again, choose to be with him.
Well, you can't change the past, I suppose. But you can learn from it and maybe help others that would have been in his same situation.
Yeah.
With what you do now.
God, I hope you're on our side.
We're gonna need everyone.
We're tearing this place apart.
That's what they'll try to do. They'll try to turn you against each other.
Has there, in your time here, been any uprisings against the games?
Little. Have you ever looked outside the window? Have you ever really looked at the cosmos?
Yeah. I mean, sorry. We're doing like a different tone.
You know what I'm talking about. Every day we see whole fragments of realms fall into a dying star.
It's beautiful. I mean, or not.
So,
but
you learn to live in the moment.
But this place, you say you see other realms falling apart, but never this place.
Not yet. Assume one day it'll happen. Who knows?
Perhaps it's its turn.
Yeah.
I knew I'm not as good with words as some, and I don't wield these incredible magics that I've seen you all do. But there's one thing I can do, it's protect those around me. I'm supposed to protect those around me. And I don't have the magic, but I hope I still have the strength of the storming ocean within me. And I will stand by your side and go as far as we can with this, because it's not right and there needs to be a balance.
I can't stand anybody who would use their position of power to exploit others for their own benefit. And it sounds like without constantly bringing in a cycle of new warriors here, that may be an end to this place. So?
No one knows for sure.
So we have to put a stop to it. We'll go straight to the top and we'll find this master of ceremonies and we will...
figure out a wish?
Yes.
That will break them.
In the meantime, I think your best move would probably be to continue competing and find out what you can.
I agree.
So, yes. My advice is to retreat to your quarters and act like none of this happened.
I think so, too. Thank you for the dinner. I'm going to go to sleep.
Thank you for being a friend to him in the end.
You're like still in his lap, right?
Yeah. Probably.
He like puts his arms around you.
Been held up by a lot of people lately.
He puts his arms around you and he says, he was a good man.
As are you.
I was rooting for him. And he reaches into his pocket and hands you a coin. And on one side is a star, and on the other is the side profile of his face. And he says, I'm a sucker for merchandise.
The merch here is really good. Thank you.
Kind of tough giving it up, but yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's like one of a kind. They don't make them anymore because it was like.
I'm so sorry. Oh, when we break all of this down, we're going to find the mint. I'll make you as many coins as you want.
I believe that you will. All right, come on.
Okay.
Go. And you retreat to the hero's repose, having put behind you the heaviest episode of this season yet. As you walk into your quarters, you are straggling behind. You feel like a small tug on your shoulder, and you see your sister kind of say, like, can we have a word? She's like, yeah. I just feel like maybe you're getting a bit attached.
To what?
You've got to look out for number one. I don't want to see you get hurt.
Yeah, for sure. I'm looking out for number one. Yeah. Hey, I got this. I can take care of myself.
I know you can.
The legends that Mom and Pop and Grandma and Grandpa used to tell us, I don't remember all of them super well, but they feel like they might be important. Do you want
They were always important.
Yeah, but they sucked. I forgot. Can you run me through that? And I promise I will pay attention this time.
She like pulls you deeper into the hall and like into like an alcove, and she says to you, we are not like
the other people here. We are from this place. I think that's what makes us destined to win. What exactly did you want to know?
There's two ways this can go. And I'll just be honest with you. I can fumble through it myself because I don't know what I don't know because I don't know enough to know what I don't know. Or you could come talk to some of these people that you're worried about and they'll know what to ask you.
I don't feel comfortable sharing our culture with people that don't even want to be here.
I understand, but...
I have to admit, though, that bit that old Russian man was saying, I had no clue that was the case.
No, I didn't know either. I knew
honestly, I don't pay enough attention to these Ferengis to even care, you know?
Truly? When they were like, we can't leave, I realized I've never inquired about leaving.
Well, yeah, this is our home.
This is our home, why would we leave? But now I'm pissed. You know what I mean? It's the thing of it's like if you were like, I'm in this great field, I can go anywhere in this field. And then after years of being in one corner of the field, they're like, actually, you can't leave this corner. And you're like, well, I never did leave this corner. But fuck you for telling me I can't. Does that resonate with you at all? It really resonates with me.
Yeah, of course it does. Yeah. I mean, I guess I'd never really thought about it, but... Well, I remember great-grandfather, before he passed, he said that there was Sahangarya. That was who he worshipped. Remember, he told us to remember those prayers and things like that. I don't think any of them stuck with you.
Not a chance, no.
But she was a goddess of ambition, of victory over tyranny, of knowledge. And she shined her light on Polakot. And it gave way to one of the greatest kingdoms of mortals. Where previously we were wanderers and lost in whatever plane we were a part of, we had purpose. And we had knowledge. We banded together and bent the land to our will, put down roots, tamed the wild animals, and made them carry out our will. And her light pushed away the darkness of ignorance, of complacency, of just scratching by. And then Babaji said that because she implanted in us this light, our people wanted to know more. You know? Why is it just enough to be fed? Why not learn everything? The secrets of the universe, the meaning of life. Understand the nature of mortality, the ethics of morals. And we gave rise to the greatest schools and the greatest wise men of thoughts. Who wanted to unravel these secrets. And they studied and pursued this knowledge with a hunger that made them question everything, including she who had given them everything. And they wondered, well, if there's Sahangarya, what other gods and goddesses are there? And you know, why do we think she's always right? And why not peel back this, I guess, curtain and look beyond it. And we grew interested in other deities and other philosophies, and a great pantheon came to Polakot to hold counsel with our ancestors, to speak to them, wise man to wise man. We erected temples, we gained new knowledge, and, well, Sahangarya felt that her chosen people no longer favored her the way they once had. And so this fueled her desire to be once again, I mean, she is the goddess of ambition, so I guess, you know, that's where we get it from. She And then Babaji says that she conspired with the Lords of Fate, Nasavani, and the Goddess of Rebirth, Resurrection, and Purification. And that's Agshani. You're not going to remember it. It's fine.
Agshani, Sahangaria, and what was the middle one?
Nasavani.
Nasavani.
You are paying attention.
Something might matter.
Oh, shit. Okay.
I'm not there yet, but I'm getting there.
So, these three, hatched a plan to steal away Polakot and its chosen people away from all of these other deities and keep it for themselves in a special little pocket. So they ripped it out of the earth and brought us here. At least that's what he said. And honestly, I never questioned it. Because are we not the chosen people? I mean, look at the people who come through here, bloodthirsty, from horrible planes, where there's hunger, war, and Babaji said that Sahangaria wanted us to save us from all those things. And here we are saved.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we are chosen. I don't think that's good news, though.
Well, why wouldn't it be?
Someone points a finger at you and says, I choose you, doesn't necessarily mean they're choosing you for something good.
Hey! Keep your head in the game.
I might be doing that for the very first time.
All we have is each other. All we have is our people. All we have is our legacy. Just because other people view this as some sort of damnation doesn't mean it is, because their opinions don't matter. What matters is us.
We matter, right?
We do matter.
What do you think? If we matter and our voices matter and our opinions matter, what do you think about this?
I want you to win.
Why?
Because I want you to ask them. I want you to ask them why our ambitious people, why we were meant to be scurried away in some pocket when we could have been the rulers of our domain, whatever we were ripped from. We are not children to be coddled.
The kind of power you're talking about is a power that we do deserve. And it's not a power that can be asked for.
I think we've earned it.
I agree. And we're gonna go earn it some more.
I need you to get it back for us. I need you to tell them we're ready. We've been training. We can do this.
Oh, they're gonna find out that I've been training. You read the books, you listened to the stories. That's one half. And I'm gonna twirl my lance and say, now it's time for part two.
She reaches out her forearm to you and says, we live forever.
As legends.
You retreat back to the quiet dormitory. There, Layla, you see a chest sitting at the foot of your bed that was not there previously.
Examine it. Slowly lift the lid.
When you lift the lid, you see a golden object in the form of two hands holding aloft an amethyst in the middle. That's the end. Whoa! Join us next week for more Battle for Beyond.
Hold on, I'm using Lucky.
This You're is when use you use it.
Yeah, luck point. There we go. Oh my 23. God.
Splitting the party. Bold choice.
Is she like awkward that he like tries to like overly kiss?
What's happening? I know what you did.
You don't know what's going on. No amount of power can help. Please don't feel bad about yourself.